Tiebreaker rule, manner of application. In every jurisdiction, in its domestic tax law, prescribes a mechanism to determine residential status of a person. If a person is considered to be resident in both the contracting states, relief sought to be given from Article 4 of the tax treaty. A series of tiebreaker rules are provided in paragraph 2, Article 4 of Model Convention to determine single state of residence of an individual. So these are as follows. Number 1. Permanent home. The first test is based on where the individual has a permanent home. A permanent home would mean a dwelling place where available to the individual for all the times, continuously and non-occasionally, and it includes place taken for rent for a prolonged period of time. Any place taken for a short period, for example, let's say for a business travel or a short holiday, it's not regarded as a place of permanent home. If this test is inconclusive for any reason that individual has permanent home available to him in both the contracting state, he will be considered as a resident of the contracting state where his personal and economic relationships are closer. In other words, if I say, the place where lies his central of vital interest. Thus, preferences given to family and social relationships, occupation, place of business, place of administration of properties, political, cultural, and other activities of the individual. This establishes a secondary criterion for two quite distinct and different situations. The case where individual has a permanent home available to him in both the contracting state and it is not possible to determine in which of his has his central of vital interest, and the case where individual has a permanent home available to him in neither of the contracting state, then in these scenarios preference is given to the contracting state where the individual has an habitual abode. If the individual has habitual abode in both the contracting state or neither of them, he shall be treated as resident of the contracting state of which he is a national. Then, if individual is a national of both the contracting state or neither of the contracting state, the matter is left to be considered by the competent authority of respective contracting states. Thank you.